Hi everyone, welcome back to DYOR. Today we are going to tear down the new iPad mini 6 2021. Before starting, we need to have the right tools to proceed with the teardown, which you can find in the description. Proper heating is required for iPad screen removal from the body. For this, we use a heating pad designed for tablets and mobile phones. On iPad devices, make sure to heat the front side. Select the tablet heating option and leave it till the heating completes. Alternatively, you can use a heat gun or something similar. Once the heating has completed, use a suction cup on the side to lift the front screen. In between, insert a few plastic pickers or car pry tools and cut the adhesive around. Be gentle while pulling the RFX cables attached to the logic board. Next, lift the LCD screen gradually and tilt about 45 degrees from the bottom. Next, remove the plate by undoing 5 screws and then disconnect the battery plug and 2 connector plugs connecting the LCD and touchscreen. Similar to iPad mini 4 and mini 5, the LCD and touchscreen come together as an assembly. There is a display assembly board vertically on the back of the right hand side of the screen. The screen assembly looks thin and separating the LCD and touch looks very hard. Next, take out the battery from the body. There are 4 adhesive tabs on the battery to peel out. If I'm correct, this is something new for iPad mini. The tabs are coming out so neatly and looks like no heating is needed. But still, there are some solid sticky under the battery's PCB. It might need some more heating or melting liquid. Here, we use a pry tool to cut the adhesive to pull out the battery. Overall, the battery removal is much easier and should get 5 purple stars instead of gold. Next, on the top right, remove the shield by undoing 3 screws. Now we are going to remove the rear camera and the flash connector. First, disconnect and take out the flex cable, and then loosen the adhesive that is holding the connector. There are four connector plugs in here. By looking at, they are the rear camera, flasher, touch ID power button, and one more that we need to figure out. Next, disconnect the antenna head and undo 5 screws around the rear camera. We chose the antenna cables and the rear camera adhesive strip. Loosen the antenna to a side and then detach the rear camera holding adhesive. Next, gently using a tweezer or pry tool, pull out the camera module. Next, apply the heat and take out the flash sensor cable. This flex cable looks fragile, be gentle and pull out the line. Next, undo 3 screws and take out the flex cable. It looks like the volume flex. Next, we are going to loosen all screws on the top section. There are 20 screws and one shield. Always pay attention to hidden screws and adhesive strips. Next, disconnect 3 antenna heads from the board and then pull out the left antenna board from the body. Next, disconnect and take out the front camera from the body. There is a hidden flex under the front camera. Be gentle and lift the front camera. Next, we will take out the copper colored rectangle flex on the right hand side and the flex under the front camera and then the rectangle shape unit from the body. We apologize and will bring the names in the description of parts after figuring out 100%. Next, take out the other left hand antenna. Next, take out the flex under the front camera. Next, take out the power button with touch ID flex. Next, on the bottom right, take out the flex cable by lifting the lever. Next, take out the antenna module by undoing 5 screws and the connector. Next, on the bottom center, undo 2 screws and pull out the Type-C charging port by disconnecting the plug. It is good news that charging port replacement is much straightforward than the other models. Finally, to pull out the logic board, first disconnect the speaker plug and then one more screw on the bottom right. And then disconnect the smart connector on the right center. Next, using a couple of pry tools, lift and take out the board. Next, if needed, can take out the logic board cover using a tweezer. In here, you can find the A15 Bionic chip and the rest. And this concludes our teardown guide in iPad mini 6. So far, we have found the battery and charging port replacements are much more easier and manageable than previous models. But still, we need to put everything back and see what issues are coming up. Stay tuned for more updates on iPad mini 6. Thanks for watching and do not forget to subscribe and hit the like button.